Hi, this is Bilal from Speckle. In previous video, I showed you how to extract category information out of received data. In this video, we're going to work with Revit parameters. Let's get started. I'll start by opening the Power Query Editor by clicking on Transform Data. And this is where we left off. We've created two queries. In first one, we have the original received data with all of its columns. And in the other one, we have extracted the category information out of the data column. So in this step, we're going to do something really similar and extract the parameters field. But first, let's examine the structure of the record object one more time. So I'll expand another wall from here, and let's make this a bit bigger just so we can see the fields of this record object. So I can see that it has an ID, it has a type, so on and so forth. It has the category, which is what we have extracted in previous video. And then it also has a parameters key, which contains all the parameters related to this object, right? And if you check its value, you can see that it's also another record object, which tells us that records can also contain records. Because of the complexity of Revit data, we can handle this structure in this way. Okay, so now, similar to the category, we can extract the parameters in two ways. The first one is by clicking on this icon, the expand record column. And then from this open dialog, we can select the parameters key. And then again, we can use the original column name as prefix, so on and so forth, and click on OK. But as we discussed before, the limitation of this approach is that you replace the existing data column and lose access to it, which is probably not what you want to do, right? So instead of expanding the existing column, we're going to add another column and we're going to extract the parameters key out of this records. Okay, so let's click on add column and custom column. And then from this dialog, let's name the column name as params, and again, it's going to be inside data, and the key we are trying to get is parameters. Okay, I'm going to click on OK, and this will add a new column which contains all the parameters. And again, these parameters are also records because of the complexity of Revit data. And actually, if you get into one of the parameters record key, you can see that it contains a bunch of default params, right? ID, speckle type, application ID, total children count, but also function param, generic height, window type ID, which the value for these parameters are also records. Because in Revit, parameters are not as simple as a key value pair. Like for the height, it's not simply a height and its value is 400 centimeters or something like that. Because parameters can be a project parameter, it can be a shade parameter, right? Can be family parameter, there are type parameters and instance parameters, so on and so forth. So they are complex data types. And in order to represent that data type inside Power BI, they have to be converted into a record object. Okay, that's why the data structure of parameters may look complex, and which is actually the case. So I'm going to quickly show you a way on how to access the relevant information from your data, basically. So let's quickly switch back to the web application and go to our server, speckle.xyz, and from our projects, let's open our project here. And actually, we can examine the structure of our data inside Speckle's web application. Okay, so let's say that you are interested in maybe one of the floors, right? So I'm going to click on this button, expand data view, and here I can see what I sent from Revit. I have the family types, the views, the materials, as well as some project information, and also elements, right? Elements contain all the 3D elements that we sent from Revit. So let's expand that one. And then I can see per category, like topography, the planting, the walls, mass, ceiling, etc. Let's say that we are interested in floors, which are highlighted. So I'm going to open that in a new window by clicking on this button. so we can see our floor elements and examine their structure isolated here. So I'm going to click on one of the objects and I can see its structure, right? It has the parameters key. Let's click on that. And then I can see all the parameters that a floor element may have, such as maybe the uniformat code or analytical roughness. The name of the parameter is stored under the name field inside the parameter object, and its actual value is stored inside the parameter object under the value field. So let's say that you are interested in the area of this floor object, right? What you need to do is you need to get into the parameter object and then get the API name of that parameter and then type in value to get the value of that parameter. It is a bit cumbersome, and that's the reality. I will show a function we have implemented in later sections of this video, which it makes this, you know, interacting with Revit parameters is really easy in Power BI. But for now, let's skip with the default method and try to extract any information from this data, right? So let's get into the host area computed, and name is area and value is 150, 50, whatever. So let's say that we want to extract the area information out of the parameters object. How do we do that? So we can see that it's inside parameters under host area computed, and its value is under the value field. So what we can do in Power BI is we can add a new column, but first let's isolate the floor elements. Okay. And from here, we can add a new column. And in this one, I'm gonna say it's area, and its value is, it is inside parameters, host, area computed, right? And then we are trying to get the value of it, right? This is our formula. So if I click on okay, so we have some errors, and let's open the formula. And it's actually, our parameters are stored under the params column, not parameters. So I'm going to replace that with params and press okay. So once you do that, you know, the area of those elements are extracted. And again, this works, but it's a bit cumbersome. So I'm going to show you a functionality we have introduced in the Speckle namespace in Power Query that makes this interaction with Revit parameters really, really easy. So let's remove the steps we have added, and our parameters are right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another reference to this query, because what I will do is I want to group my model by their categories. Okay, let's do that. So I'm going to go to the Home tab and click on Group By. And from this dialog, I want to group my data by their categories. And the new column we're going to add will store all the data about them. And the operation is all rows. We want to have all rows in one cell, and click on OK. So once you do that, all the categories will be in one column right here, and all the elements belonging to that category will be stored in separate tables like this. So let's say that we are interested in floors, right? So I'm going to find floors, which is right here. And then right click on this table and click on add as new query. And also let's get back to the previous query and rename this to grouped by category. And then I will also uncheck enable load so it doesn't load into the Power BI report. Okay, so let's go back to our floors, and here is all the floors. If I check the speckle type of all the data, I can see that I have some element types as well as some instances. So when we sent from Revit, we have sent everything, including the types, you know, floor types. And in this case, you may not be interested in, you know, floor types, What you can do is simply filter those out by clicking on this arrow icon, and instead of selecting all, I will select only the floor elements. Okay, perfect. Now we are ready. So what we will do is we will add a new column to our table, and in this column we will have our parameters. But instead of parameters as record elements, we will have their name as the name field and their value as the value field instead of a record and a bunch of default Speckle parameters. So let's do it. I will click on Add Column and Custom Column, and this column will be named as parameters. Instead of adding a new column, you can also transform the existing column, which is a bit more complex for a beginner. That's why I am adding a new column instead of transforming the existing one. So what I want to do is I want to call a functionality that lives under the Speckle namespace. So I'll type in Speckle dot and then Revit dot, as you can see, parameters dot to name value record. This is the function we want to call. So this function expects a record, which is under the params column. So what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to type in params and close parentheses. So the function we call is speckle.revit.parameters.toNameValueRecords, and inside that we put in the record objects from this column and press OK. And we will have a new column now, but the difference between these two will be if I expand one, you can see it contains the names of the parameters as well as their values. So the room bounding is true. So it's not as cumbersome as the previous method I showed you. Okay, so this makes interacting with parameters so much easier. So now what I can do is I can expand this new column. So we will extract the area, type name, and volume. And we also don't want to use the original column name as prefix, and click OK. And ta-da, the area, the type name, and the volume. Okay. So now let's go back to Power BI and do some, you know, coloring and visualization with it. Okay, so here we are, and the floors query is right here. Let me get back to the bottom left corner. So what we can do is in the tooltip data, instead of category, and this time I'm going to use maybe the type name. And now only floors elements are isolated. And what we can do is we can maybe color them by their area if we wanted to. And here they are, colored by their area. And let's also color them by their type name. So on and so forth. So we can also create, you know, other custom visuals using the built-in visuals in Power BI. So this is it. In this video, I showed you how to, you know, interact with Revit parameter objects in Power Query. First, I showed you the default method of extracting any parameter you want, which was a bit more cumbersome. And then I also showed you how to use the new function we have added in the Speckle namespace and how it makes interacting with Revit parameters so easy. And finally, we have added the tooltip data and colored, you know, the floors or any other category of element by the parameters we have extracted. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below, or even better, at speckle.community, our forum. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.